Okay, right, so this is Voyage Century. Here we go. I'm just going to check for updates at the moment. This game's pretty intense. There's so much things in this game, it's not funny. What you basically do is you train up your character, and you trade resources around the world, meet interesting people, and sometimes kill them. It depends. But yeah, as you can see, it's got a little update happening here. There's an item mall where you can pay some money to get some items if you really want to, but you can actually succeed fairly well in this game without buying stuff, and I'll hopefully show you some of that in this video series. Alright, so here's the main screen, I guess. It does matter which server you choose. I'm on the Columbus server, but if you want to play with your friends, you all have to choose the same server. So, what you have to do is you go to IGG, the website, and you sign up using my code as well if you want some extra free items at the very beginning. I'll also briefly touch on in this one. Alright, so I started off with Hornet characters because this is my other account, this is my alt's account. So I deleted a character and make a new one. Just so you can see the process. You can't change anything at the beginning apart from the hair colour and skin colour. So there she is, Voshus. Wonderful character for my Mountain Blade series, which has ended because there's so many updates and I have to reinstall it and all that. Anyway, let's get into this. You'll start off with a nice little world map here. Nice little introduction. Explains the journeys from the from Rome all the way around to Asia and such. Most of the levels will be focusing on around Europe and Athens and things like that, and up to Stockholm, and yeah, so at the beginning you'll be with this sort of area, and as you can see I'm pressing P a lot because P is the button I'm using to record in Fraps, which probably isn't beneficial, but anyway. So you can see a big exclamation mark across this guy's head, who's invisible at the moment for some reason. But that's Langer, you've got to talk to him, that's the very first person you have to talk to. And choose your profession, which you can see there, and it does matter which one you choose because all of the clothing depends on what profession you choose. And different professions, as you can see there, have different skills, which you can't read them all, which is pretty frustrating, but you get the hang of it. And it's a good idea to have multiple characters anyway, so you can test them all out, just in case you balls it up, so to speak. So anyway, that little button there goes to the quest guide, and anything which is green and underlined you can just click to and it will go to straight away. So it's a bit easier to navigate for the new players. And as you can see, she wants to have a pistol because she's an armed businessman. So there you go, she's got a pistol. She's armed and dangerous. And when these little speech bubbles come up, you can't do anything but click them out. And when there's a screen covering it, you can't read it, so sometimes that's a bit frustrating. Sorry about that. But anyway, let's continue on. So she wants me to go to, he wants me to go to the skill tutor, who is up here, and she'll just walk there by herself. And all these other buttons that you see around, I'll explain as well, so it's not so confusing. And here's the skill tutor. Now, things that are blacked out, don't worry about that, because all that's saying that all that is saying that you haven't brought them yet. So you can buy them, and that's actually how you pass that quest, because all you need to do is get one, but I'm gonna buy one or two more, I think. No? It's pre-recorded. Okay, to Vern. Vern will say, do this and that. You basically just want to click on the links, and she'll start running. Sometimes she might get stuck on the terrain. I think they're still trying to work out those bugs. She sometimes avoids them or walks through them. Just a quick explanation on people who sell stuff at vendors. This person here... Well, you can hold down Alt and you can see everyone's name. And all the NPCs. And even things on the ground. So... let's see what this is. Okay. My profession skills. So if I want to use a medikit, there would be a boost on that. She's proficient in shooting, so I get that skill. Wounding skill, I think it was. Alright, two vendors. Now, some vendors sell some really good items and some of them don't. And as you can see here, this one's quite expensive. Not bad items, but at the moment I don't have $9 million to, you know, slosh around. All these NPCs you use later, I won't worry about them. These guys under the tents here, these are the markets where you can sell and buy stuff. I'll come back to them a bit later, a few times. Don't worry about that. There's the map. Easy way to navigate with this, and you can see everything at once. Around your area, zoom in and out and such. Alright, so let's go into here. Continue on with the mission. The quest, sorry. Anyway, quest guide, talk to that person who's standing right there, level up, clickety clickety click. This person wants some seafood. So you have to go and kill some turtles and crabs. Poor little crabs on the beach. And slaughter them. And slash them up. Make some nice sushi. Maybe. Sushi's really fish, isn't it? I guess I'm not really correct on that. Anyway, you can expand that and you can see everything that's has happened throughout the game for a short period of time. You can see what points you got, how much cash you got, what items you got. People can somehow get on the podiums. I'm not quite sure about that yet. Oh, she's stuck there. Yeah, I'm not quite sure about most of the stuff in this game. I mean, it's pretty intense. Now, this is the AFK system. It's really, really good. I suggest using it most of the time, because it helps quite a bit. So what you want to do is you want to set the health at which you'll drop to and then start healing with an interval of 2, because at 1 it just conflicts and says you can't take a potion at this interval, you have to change it to 2. So anyway, SP and HP. HP is your health obviously, and SP is your stamina points. Both can be influenced by potions. So I'm going to turn on automatic killing, and so I don't really have to do anything whatsoever. She'll just run around and shoot stuff and get points as she goes along. And the points that fly up above her head, the yellow is for the bar down the bottom, and the red is for the weapon, I think. Weapon skill, and that changes every time you change weapon and whatnot. So at the very start you get a free suit, put on the Land Star, so she's got more health, more SP, more defense, and kick the turtles in the face. Personally I wouldn't kill a turtle like that, and even if I had to I probably would stomp it. Anyway. Kicks your turtle in the face. Anyway. Okay, time for the crabs, and I'm wondering why I'm not actually picking up anything heavy. Even though I'm sure I changed that in the AFK, but it turns out that I didn't, and so I haven't been picking up items all this time, except for money. Which is not good at this point, because I want to pick up some crab pincers. See, she's not picking up anything, and I'm thinking, oh, I might be on random. Well, it is on random, but I'm saying that the drops might be a bit more rarer. And you see all these other people kicking and killing stuff, even though they're levels beyond me. That's because there's a shortbread competition on. Or shortbread event, sorry, which is the beggar event envoy. I'll explain that just in a little bit later on. But all you basically do is pick up shortbreads and you have to give him 50 and your character will get a huge amount of points. It's like 2 million extra experience points in eloquence and the main experience. So yeah, it's a really big boost. You'll go from level 10 to level 30. Anyway, so back to getting some crab pincers. I'm going to get more than I need because I know that there's a mission right near where I'm going to be ending this mission for crab pincers, so I get a bit more money and experience. So yeah, da-da-da, kick. Takes a long time, I realise it takes a very long time, but it's all worth it. What you can do is press tab while she's in this auto attack mode, so you can select a different target before the rest of them do, which is sometimes handy. As you can see there, I've got some bad crystal and bad steel. I'll be explaining that a little bit later on as well, but basically all they do is refine weapons which are glowing, or jewellery which is glowing, and below level 70 or something. Take that, you crab! Okay, so last crab. I'll just let it kill this one. Oh jeez, come on. What's that? It's a whole lot of information which you don't have to focus on yet, basically. Okay, so let's continue on. And that too, don't have to, that's for booth stuff. Don't worry about that yet. These two characters on the side there, I don't talk to them because they need certain items which you either have to buy or you find somewhere later on in the game. Alright, so that's the bank clerk there. You can deposit money if you want to. And let's continue on with this mission. Walking through the streets of Athens. Okay, back to the tavern. Let's talk to this lady in the red dress over here. da. She gives you some more money. She tells you to go buy some potions. And right click to equip. So I've got a ring there, which helps me with health and energy or stamina. Okay, so what does she want me to buy? Oh, this gets a bit tricky. Overlaps. Can't do anything. Rah! Alright, so this mission, this quest, she wants me to buy 5 of both. It's quite easy. You have to go to item tab. 5 of each. Done. Talk to him as well. This is the guy who has the extra mission. You have to click apply join. Apply to join, whatever. Crab pincers, done. Beautiful. 8 more grand. See, money goes fairly quickly in this game once you want to buy more studs and you want to buy more items for your boat or your character. Just money goes out the pockets. Everything burns a hole in the pocket. There's a Stegosaurus as a pet, as you do. Okay, what's this mission? I have to go over here. Free thing there, that didn't really help. But what I really want to do is buy that stunt. A falcon's better than a sword, what I hear, but they're both pretty good. The axe is also very good, but I don't buy that at the moment. And I'll buy some skills later, and I'll show them. But not yet. And then with the stunts you get little extras and they cost about $200 to $3,000. They go ridiculous prices. That's where your money goes. Your money goes into all of them, different levels of them later on. It just gets intense. I think my last the cost of my last skill for one of my other characters was something like $5 million. That was pretty interesting. So yeah, let's get some health here. Some medic skill. Some skills for at sea, which I'll show you in the next video. Well, a couple videos later. This is quite a long video. Series. Whatever. Anyway. Alright, let's go hunting, shall we? Alright, we're in Athens suburbs. There are no houses, of course. There's an amphitheatre. And there's a little temple up on the mountain. And some farmers. That's about it. But, the further you go into the suburbs, different mobs of different rank appear, I guess. Different, I don't know what you call it, what part of the mobs get, the further you get in. But of course this is just Athens, so the only animals which really do damage, well, none of them really, only the depressed poet really hurts you later on. But even he's not that hard, we just slice him up. So yes, I'm gonna kill all these pheasants, and oh, I got a shortbread. That's 1 out of 50. So, yeah, as I said before, those events only happen on the weekend. And when you do happen to get 50, you can go to either Seville or Athens, and the beggar event envoy should be there. Actually, while she kills stuff, I'll set up this little bar down the bottom and I'll explain that. It's basically keyboard shortcuts from F1 to F12, and yeah, you can place items in there, and it's just really good way of using things. So like the bad crystal and the bad steel, as I'll show later, can be used as that bar. But if you click on the icon, it will use it, but if you right click it will delete it. We'll just remove it from that selection. See, now I can't use the bad crystal on an equipped item, so see that? That worked. Little bonus on there. Nice. And I don't think I'll be able to use it on this weapon because it's not glowing. Nope. So I have to use it on... Oops, I deleted it. Use it on the gun. Succeeded. See? Beautiful. And what I did there is I right click on the bad steel and then go to the other tab. You don't have to put it in the bar, but it does help when you've got over 100 of them. And you don't want to be going right click, over to the tab, click, back again, back again, back again. You'd just rather be pressing an F number button over and over again, and then on the item, and it just does it really quickly, refines the item. So yeah, back to killing more innocent little foxes. Well, actually they're a pest, but anyway, that's the last one. Let's go to Grant. Let's go, come on. No? We'll have to do what? What is she doing? Ah, yes. I'm gonna get a sheep horn. A bellwether horn, I should say. Sheep horn doesn't sound very good, does it? So, alright, let's get this horn. It might not. Alright, so that's the mission, basically. See how it says hasn't been authenticated? That's a mission just after this one. You have to authenticate a bellwether. And how you do that is you have to get a sheep horn. So did I get it? I think I did. I got a shortbread as well, which is very nice. And I think the reason why mobs drop items is because they eat certain things. And then you basically are cutting open their guts and you're fishing that back out. So yeah, very nutritious. But that, you know, that kind of explains zombies in Minecraft dropping feathers, or wolves dropping hats and clothing because, you know, they've eaten a human and you're retrieving their belongings from their gullet. Before it's digested, of course. Okay. So now we have to go to Pascal and give him this bellwether horn, the sheep horn. He loves a bit of sheep horn. Sheep. Bad. Bad boy. Alright, so got another ring there, equip that. Okay, so this guy's name is Identifiers, but really it's Pascal. It's a bit confusing. Alright, so you talk to him once, and you gotta say... Findings of it... Okay, so this little screen here, it says Volume Authentication or Findings Evaluation, I think. And so I've only got one, so I'll just go, yep, thank you. And that's now done. You're going to talk to him one more time. And there you go. So volume authentication is pretty handy if you know that you've got all the items for identifying things, and he'll just go through them and you'll get all the experience and the reputation and the money, and yeah, it's just, yeah, that's how it works. Alright, so we're going to buy one of these, one of these, and one of these. Don't worry if it's red, that just means you can't use it, but you can still buy it. Alright, so what can I sell to him? He's got gold and moulds and wood and everything which you can kind of get, apart from the moulds, I think, and drawings, which will help you craft items using your foundry skill. But anyway, let's get back to the mission. I'll explain all that at a later time. Running through the streets of Athens on the paths of cobblestone. And now the streets I walk alone. Down the streets of cobblestone. Da 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 da. That's the arena where it's person versus person, but there's no experience when you kill someone. It's just testing out your abilities. Might show that later. Anyway, let's talk to Grant. He's offered to give me a bunch of weapons. You can only choose one, of course. And I'm going to choose the wrong one by accident, which is a sword, which I can't use. But anyway, may as well learn that skill later on. I kind of bolstered it up, but doesn't matter. Alright, so this is a mining area. That guy there is stopped either because his pick isn't good enough or he's got no energy left. But yes, I'll explain that later, don't worry. I'll get to mining and harvesting and all that fun stuff later on. Now I'm going to go to my map here and look for the blue dots, because they're plants. And very soon I'm going to have a mission where I need to get linen and jute. So I have to get two of each, and I think I could get a little bit more than that, but more the merrier, of course. And yes, I'll probably do a little bit of planting later, just to show you how that works. Even though I've never used a planting card, because, I don't know, I've just been slack. I've never really needed to use it. So now this logger with blonde hair, in the picture he has brown hair, that's fine, don't worry about that. It's all an illusion, it's fine. Jute over there. I think jute's for making either SP bottles or HP bottles later on, when you get your alchemy skill up and cranking. There's some linen there. This is used for making cloth, so you can make your own garments and things. But that is all to come. That's all later on. Don't worry about it. Now we're on the long road to the farmers. So you can see this guy here with his pet dragon, and he's using a planting card. Can't resist the linen, have to pick it up. He's just humming away there. It's quite a popular spot for farmers. Nice little secluded area. you talk to him and you give him the seeds. And he's like, oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Come on. See? Need the seeds. Done. He gives you a backpack. Then you run back to Grant. That's right. Run back to Grant. I wonder how many times people have given him seeds and he's run out. How many backpacks of Grant does he have? A lot of backpacks. Anyway, sorry about it. It's just a story. It's just an illusion in the story. It all makes sense. She gets stuck on the trees halfway through the middle, but don't worry about that. Anyway. Alright, back to Grant. He'll be like, oh, cheers. Thank you, love. Moving right on to Vern, I think. Isn't it Vern? Can't read it from here. Anyway. Run, run, run. Looking at the map here. I'm the green triangle. Moving this way. Talk to Vern. What does he want me to do? Oh, talk to this person. Alright, jeez. Only because I trust you, Vern. Now, I thought I might have accidentally stuffed the whole thing because I have already brought two stunts for the bear arm. The, you know, the fists. And it says in the quest to buy them now, but it doesn't matter. It's all good. Because it says completed, so no panic. Person, da da da, what do you want me to do? You want me to kill someone? Are you serious? Kill the depressed poet. Kill him! He's depressed. Kill him! Okay, getting towards the end here, not very long to go, only about 10 minutes, I think. Oh, can't go that way. Alright, let's go around. It's a long journey to the depressed poet. He lives up in the hills. You can just see the top of the building there. Run all that way just to kill him. Can't call him down and call him out and say, look, get happy, or they're just gonna kill you. No, can't tell him that. Just gonna slice his head off and use it as a basketball or whatever.
Use his head as a basketball?
Something like that, and you find it a lot later on. Don't worry about it yet. As you can see, people are hoarding around him, wanting to kill him. So it might be tricky to actually get a hit on him, so sometimes it's a good idea to start teaming up with people. That way their kills is also added to your kills. And same with the experience, you get a little bit of a debuff with that. Someone wanted to, but they just left. So, yeah, a little bit tricky, but yeah, that's what happens in this game. You're just gonna work around the hard bits, so to speak. Work around the other players. Anyway, let's slice him up. Slice him up. Did I get the first hit in? I might have. Come on. Yes.
Mission completed.
Oh. Gonna take off auto kill, or she'll be there all night, and she won't stop killing. But I'll let her kill it. Getting so close now, come on. I'm just gonna get up to the mission where you can actually leave the port and yeah, take a break for a bit. Ever so close to the end now. Alright. So, mission complete with that one, and he wants me to do the first order and start learning trade with goods and fruit and watches and mirrors and marijuana and all that stuff. Wait, what? Marijuana? Yes, that's right. Rum and vodka, just everything. But a little tip with that. Okay, we're gonna go to the trader now, aren't we? Every city you go to, you'll find a trader, and you'll have to take note of what he's selling, because some cities have the same items, but if you try to sell them the same items, of course it's not gonna get you any reward, is it? So anyway, oh, I clicked the wrong thing, don't know about that. He wants to explain trade and all that, I'll just quit out of it and go, yeah, whatever. Give me fruit. No, give me seafood. Yes, that's right. Give me seafood, damn you. Anyway, look at the seafood. Go back to this guy. And so, yeah, different cities will, regard different items at a different price, and they'll value things differently, but I think that changes every so often, just to keep things a little bit interesting for the people that like to trade. Like, sometimes you'll see server announcement, rum in, I don't know, rum in Istanbul has gone up, you know. Okay, so this is the beggar envoy guy. You say exchange reward and receive quest, and he'll say, yep, cool, so I've only got that much at the moment. But when I do, bang, my character is at level 30, I betcha. Alright, so for the docker, all we've got to do is get 700 of these, because we've already got 300, which will make 1,000. And sailors, so we've already got, I think it was, I don't know, I get 25 and it says complete, so I think I only had to get 20. But 5 more is good, just for, you know, bit of work. Okay, so on your boat screen you've got 2 boats in sail. The level 1 boats are actually the best boats at the moment. Well, until you get level 9 raiding ships, they're the best. Or really big merchant ships, they're good as well. But you can swap your boat by going to the docker and saying dock and then getting that boat out. But I'm not going to worry about doing that at the moment. Okay, so what are we doing? We have to go back here. Talk to this guy. Yeah, I'm not sure what that little repair thing there is. It's pretty snazzy, and there's a couple of little small icons there. Though I'm not really sure what they do, but interesting nonetheless. Okay, so that's done. He wants me to go to Istanbul. Right. Finally. Time to get out to the ocean. It's been a long journey. Just this first couple of missions. They take some time, but you can, kill two birds with one stone occasionally. It's been fun. I've done it a fair few times with a fair few characters, and waste of time. It's good fun though. Alright, I'll show you the warehouse. Price taken is for when you choose the buzz code when you register to IDD. I've got price taken twice and all. Items, it won't let me now, of course. But let's go to inventory and just put some stuff in there. Your basic warehouse. And there's one in every city, but you've got to buy more. I think about 50 grand to start your own warehouse in a different city. And just going to put the gold that I found laying on the street here. But if anyone asks me for that, going back, I'm just going to give it back to them, of course. Because it's just gold that I can't really use at the moment. Let's sell it, you know? Anyway. But you never know, I might need to use it sometime. Alright, so yeah, finally I can go to the docker and a little explanation about these sea mermaids. Now, you get a free one each time you do that last mission I just completed. Now, most people end their character here, give that sea mermaid to their main character, and then sell it for about $2 to $5 million, or silver. So, yeah, it's completely optional, but I recommend that you keep them. Anyway, I'll be back. See ya.